Van Cliburn, the musical conqueror of Moscow, returns to a hero's welcome in New York.
When you go out to play a performance of classical music, you're trying to recreate a painting in sound, because music is to time what painting is to space.
When we first learned that the hall, specifically the concert hall, would be named after Van, it was so fitting. And it was also really fitting that it wasn't something that he had necessarily sought after from us in our conversations about TCU or the School of Music or even the piano department. I know that was the desire of so many of his friends and loved ones in naming the hall after Van, was that there could be this legacy, that there could be this remembrance, but also amidst that legacy and remembrance, celebration. And certainly there is no better place to celebrate music than in a concert hall.
Early on, when this was still on the drawing board, we were over in the Fine Arts Building, which is right across from the Schieffer School of Journalism. And it occurred to me, Bob Schieffer, TCU grad, it's really wonderful to have his name on that. So when people come to TCU, they understand what TCU's contributed. And we thought, if they're building a concert hall and a school of music, Van Cliburn's name should be on it. He did not graduate from TCU, but he was very involved with TCU. And as I mentioned, he, obviously, the competition, which is now one of Fort Worth's premier cultural activities, started here in 1962 at Ed Landreth Hall, and some of the competitors that won the Van Cliburn competition came to teach at TCU. Obviously, he was given an honorary doctorate from TCU, but he was very involved with the school, and his contribution here lives on. So we felt his name really belonged to be in the building and on the hall.
Music at its core requires performance, right? To experience music requires that there be a performance of some kind. And that's a two-way street. That's the musician performing, and then that's the audience or the person listening, you know, receiving and understanding what's happening. So performance is at the heart of what we do in a school of music. We need to make sure that students have ample opportunities to perform and that they have the right tools to perform. What does that mean? That means access to the most talented instructors. That means access to high quality instruments. And it also means access to high quality and state-of-the-art performance spaces.
First and foremost, we built the concert hall to serve the academic programs here at TCU. But it's going to be much, much more than that. It's going to be a beacon for the importance of music to the community, to the state. I envision that we will have people who will be traveling from other cities and states who want to perform here because they want to have this experience in this extraordinary hall.
There's not a bad seat in this hall. Everybody says that about a new hall. But I've gone around in this hall, and even when Dr. Gibson first allowed me to see the hall, that was one of the first things that I was impressed with. Any place in this hall, you have a good view of the stage, and the acoustics are going to be good. That is rare. And I have to give credit to Dr. Gibson for that, because he oversaw every aspect of this place and made sure that things like that were important, and they are. So from an audience standpoint, the Van Cliburn Hall is special. And that's the other aspect. Not only is it special to the students, but you're going to a concert that's the Van Cliburn Concert Hall. That says something. You expect a certain quality because of the name, because of Van.